Multiply here, and today snapshots in Isotope Ozone, which is how to get your EQ right if you're mastering, because it can be a nightmare. Because you're like, is your mongs what you're doing, playing tricks on me, I don't trust you. Or maybe you're like, room, what's wrong with you, you're giving me the wrong sound. So it's nice to kind of check your EQ using snapshots. It's basically a way of getting your track you're mastering the same frequency EQ balance as your reference track, which is your reference track is your kind of your template, your ideal track that you want to kind of get your shit sounding like. So I'm going to show you how to do it in Isotope Ozone. Let's go. Right, so you want your reference track. In this case, because I make a lot of the bro step, the kind of angry dubstepy type shit, we're gonna use Knife Party's Bonfire as the reference. So do you want to drag that probably into arrangement view? Yeah, that'll do. Now I'm not gonna actually play it through the speakers, because otherwise this video gets taken down, because yeah, YouTube mongs. So doesn't matter though. I'm just going to turn, what's it called? Hopefully if I turn this down, it'll still work. If not, I'll fix it. Right, Isotope Ozone. So right now, loaded up Ozone, we're going to want to take a snapshot of the reference track, in this case, Bonfire. So what I'm going to do is quickly check that this will work, how I've set this up. Yep, should be fine. Now my video won't get taken down. So how do you take a snapshot of the whatever you call it, reference track? Well, you got your Ozone, navigate to equalizer, whack that big button, boing, next to equalizer, and then click snapshots, and then this loads up. Now I'm gonna delete all these other ones I was making earlier, and you'll have something that looks like this. Get rid of pink. It'll look exactly like this. If it doesn't, make it look like this, but I'm pretty sure it will look exactly like this. Right. So how'd you take a reference kind of snapshot? Start at the beginning, press start capture, and then let it play out until you get to maybe, well, until, actually I can probably talk because it's playing. So yeah, start at the beginning, click start capture, and then start the track. Now you'll see what's going on is the sound's not coming out because I turned the fader down, but this is Bonfire, the reference track, playing through Isotope Ozone, and it's capturing basically this is a spectrum like analyzer of the frequencies, but it's storing the maximum amplitudes. So if like there was a 200 hertz bit that made that mound, and then even if it's gone away, it stays there because this is like the maximum over an infinite amount of time. Pretty obvious, right? It's a pretty simple concept. This goes from the low frequencies to the high frequencies, decibels. So what you have is, as the track's playing, it's showing you where each frequency from 50 up to like 2k, each frequency is reaching. And obviously you need to wait till the main part of the song has happened, because otherwise you won't have all the frequencies represented, because obviously in the main part of the song there are bits playing that weren't in the intro. But over time, probably in another 16 bars or so, I can be sure that this kind of curve that's left is the kind of the spread, the balance, whatever you want to call it, of frequencies that we want to match our bro steppy shit to. That's pretty much there. Just leave it a little bit more. Sweet, yeah, that should do. Stop capture. Now we have the kind of like ideal balance of frequencies for the genre, because it's worth noting different genres master shit in different ways and give different sounds, so different genres tend to have different snapshots and basically different kind of balance of frequencies. This is very, very standard for the brostep, dubstep, modern, current, kind of distorted bass music, whatever you want to call it. And rocky chair, it rocks, that's nice. So this is what kind of most brostep looks like. Ignore the little peaks, it's the general kind of shape in this case. That general shape is what you want, and you want to get your track quite close to it, but it doesn't matter if it's not perfect. Bonfire is a very good example of a very well-made track. Rob Swire is a genius, so just basically pick whatever track you trust and what other people have generally said is an amazing mixdown. And Knife Part is shit, especially this EP. It's well known for being absolutely perfect of the genre. So, you got your snapshot. What you want to do is probably save set, and then just call it whatever, Knife Party Bonfire, save. And then what you can do, you can delete that, and you can bring up, I might as well delete that, why not, bring up your track. In this case, I'm going to illustrate it with one of my own, which is kind of similar sort of genre, even though it's electro, bass invading, pre-master. Hopefully it'll work. I haven't actually checked it, but it's like jazz improvising, nothing wrong with that. So we go to Isotope Ozone, load it up. Now I'm not going to master everything, I'm just going to show you the snapshot on the EQ side of things. So we got my track, click the equalizer button, turn it on. I think you might have had to do that before, I might not have mentioned that. And then whether or not you used matching or snapshots before, just click it, it will turn up. And then in this case, the snapshot stayed there. Sometimes it doesn't, so just delete. If it's not there for whatever reason, load, this is why you save it. Knife Party Bonfire, and then boing, it's appeared. Now you can actually name these, which is what I should have done. I spelt it wrong. Who gives a fuck, right? It's only a tutorial. And then you save it and this name will stay the same. Now we have basically the snapshot. You can toggle it off and on. Also worth noting, if you start another capture, you can kind of line up as many here as you want. So for example, I've got three perfect brostep ragers. And there's three appears. And you can kind of store as many as you want. If you say got a few tracks in a genre, you're not sure which is the kind of perfect EQ balance, load up a few, take the average, whatever you want to do. So how do you actually match your track to the track that you want to kind of master? Well, what you're going to want to do is take a snapshot of your track. And how do you do that? Same way as before. So we've gone to snapshots, we need to do start capture, play, and now it's taking a snapshot of the track we're mastering. So just gotta wait for this shit to happen, and then shouldn't be too long. Remember, little kind of peaks like here and here, they're just song specific, they don't matter. It's just the general shape and the rough level. So stuff like the bass needs to be roughly... I clicked something, it happened. Uh-oh, they're at the beginning. I think I fucked it up. Delete, start capture. Don't click the equalizer, something weird happens and I don't trust it. So start again. So yeah, back to what I was talking about. It's just the general kind of level. So like the bass needs to be kind of up here somewhere. And the general shape needs to be kind of like that. For this genre, remember. Brostep is kind of slightly different territory to normal. I say normal, just kind of less aggressive music. So, yeah, just let that play out. And then it's really, really good the way you do the matching. Just show you in a second. Rocky chair, rocky chair. What I could have done is probably save these snapshots ahead of time. Whatever. Okay, it's only a few minutes. It's nearly done. Just got to let a little bit of the main section play out. And then we can be good. Cool. It's looking like the snapshot has kind of settled that shape. Cool. Stop capture. Stop the track. And now we have my track in capitals. So we have the yellow is mine. Now you'll notice in this case, just turn off the other one, I've got loads of peaks. Now, depends on the style of the track. It tends to be the kind of the smootherly, what's the best way of describing it, like the more distorted it is, while kind of keeping the weird resonant frequencies away, the kind of the flatter it'll be. Whereas if it's more less distorted, I don't know, whatever, play a load of tracks, kind of get a load of snapshots, you'll get a feeling for what tracks have what kind of spiky bits. And there's nothing wrong with it, although I'd say this is about the absolute limit of how spiky you want it. If you have it any more spiky, you probably want more distortion. But this Bonfire track is an example of a very distorted, very cleverly distorted track, because it's really, really flat, not many peaks. So the Rob Swire, basically, he's got, like me, all these notes, but then he's filled it in really cleverly with distortion. Now, I didn't do it for my track, just because I didn't want that, but it's worth noting what the peaks are. So now you see my track, you compare mine's the yellow, it's not too far off, but you see it's kind of, his is more flat and then tapers off a bit, mine's kind of down and then flat and then tapers slightly too much. So we want to just nudge it a bit. Remember, subtlety is everything in this. You don't want to be matching shit like crazy. So you go to matching, and then we see Knife Party, Bonfire, and my track. We want to match, I think it's apply to my track from Bonfire. So you'll see, just click apply to my track, match from Knife Party, Bonfire, click match. And now you'll see this shape. And that you basically, after that, you got two sliders, amount and smoothing. Pretty obvious. Amount is how close it tries to get. Obviously, you just don't want to be in this top two thirds, to be honest. That's just what happened is, if you do this, it will sound too unnatural. Because what you're not doing is, you don't want to change the sound of the song. You just want to tweak the balance a little bit to give you the best chance possible. It's not major stuff we're doing. So for example, we want more that than that. Makes sense? Just a little bit, little nudge, it's all good. And smoothing, best showed if we make the amount big, smoothing smooths it out. So you never know, maybe it makes more sense to have the amount more in the middle, but then have it smoothed off quite smooth, and that way it kind of keeps the sound there. Because if you start having smoothing like that, you'll change the complete sound of the song. It's trying to match it too perfectly. You don't want that. I'm sure you know that. So it's pretty sweet the kind of way you can change the smoothing and the amount. So in my case, I probably want something like, if I was doing this, I'd say about that. And then what I do is, separately, I try and, actually I might leave it like that, the very top end, maybe in post equalizer, I'd kind of take it off from about 17 18k down, because you can't really hear 17k upwards, but ignore that a bit, we can fix that. You see here, it's just a very slight nudging, it just gives you a basic shape, and this will push my track towards the reference. Sorted, and that's it. Done. You can probably go to EQ bands, maybe tweak it if you need to do some separate stuff. But to be honest, if you need to do anything other than this snapshot matching thing, if it's your track, go back to the mix. You've got a major mix problem. If it's like your bass is just majorly way out of sync with the snares or whatever, and suddenly you need to do something retarded, fix it in the mix. This snapshots and matching is probably all you need, because remember, at the mastering stage, EQ should only be like subtle, fine tweaking. It shouldn't be major shit. This is mastering, it's not mixing. Remember that. You can't fix everything in mastering, so don't just assume you can. Unless, of course, you're mastering someone else's shit, in which case you may need to do something slightly more radical before this, but this should be all you need. Snapshots and matching. And yeah, that's kind of it, man. Just click match and then fuck it, I've told you what to do. Done. 15 minutes. It took a while, but there you have it. That's kind of a really, really useful tip, I thought. Really, really useful feature of Isotope Ozone. Hope you found it useful. It's something that, unless you get told it's there, you probably don't even know it's in Ozone, but it's fucking useful, man. Seriously. It's like, it's so hard to, like, if you see this like final EQ curve I've ended up with, there'd be no way for me to know how to do that without comparing it to a reference, because like you've got so many things in the signal chain, from like your preamp to the audio interface to like your headphones and then your ears and then your environment or whatever else you're doing. It's nice to kind of do a more scientific fix to kind of get things sounding the way they should. And trust me, you can reference Rob Swire. He knows his shit. Yeah, pick someone good. Don't just pick one track. Maybe what I do is I picked maybe 8 or 9 of my favorite tracks, and then I kind of found out where the rough average was, and then picked a track that was in the average. Because although there's like 8 or 9 tracks I consider like perfect bro set, it wasn't until I checked them all in the snapshots thing that I realized Bonfires is a perfect example. Yeah, and there you have it. Be sure to run a lot of tracks through the snapshots and just analyze them, have a look before you start using it. Otherwise, you'll probably start using it incorrectly. So it's worth having at least a small intuition with how the snapshots look. Otherwise, it's going to sound weird and you're going to do something wrong. And remember, just don't do anything that changes the sound too much. Although mastering is more science than the rest of the process, still a little bit of an art. So it's not just a case of you want to just match it for the sake of it and then say, oh, my ears must be lying to me, because, yeah, use your common sense. Don't be a mong. Cool. I've been Multiplier. Check out all my links and shit below. Sweet. Enjoy matching. Yeah.